Hi, this video is about the filters feature in the product catalog. I'll tell you what filters, search field, and sorting are, and how to add these options to your online store. I've created a project with filters, search, and sorting already added. Filters look like controls. As you can see, they are located near the product grid. They help you navigate the cards and look through just those cards that fit the filters selected. For example, you can set the price range, that is, specify the lowest or the highest price, select the specific brand, color, or several colors, and you'll get only those product cards that fit your requirements and filters selected. The search field allows you to find the goods by typing the values. For example, you can type chair, and the relevant goods will be displayed. The sorting allows you to change the display order of the products on the page. So let's figure out how to add filters. For this example, I've created a separate project, created a new page and added the block containing product cards from the store category, turned on the catalog by clicking the product catalog in the content tab, and get started with product catalog. I've also added product cards to the catalog. And now in the content tab of the block, I select to show all products from the catalog on the page. To apply the changes, I click Save and Close and publish the page. To add filters, let's click Products tab to go to the catalog, then Filters, Create New Filter option and select the filter type to add. Filter type is the product information that will be used in filtering. This can be a category or a brand or a price range or availability or variant options or characteristic. The types available for the filters you create depend on the information added about the products. For example, I have details for the variant options and characteristic types in the product cards, that is, color and material. So I can add filtering by variant options and by characteristic. Let's click the category type, and some additional options appear. They also depend on the filter type selected. If you select another type, there can be other options. In this example, I have filter title and type of control. You can select between one variant of value and multiple variants of value in the type of control option. Let's see how they differ. I go to the page with filters added. Click the category filter, and you can select just one value for this filter, either accessories or furniture. When clicking on the color filter, you can select several values, gray, blue, black colors, and the product card that contains at least one of these values will be displayed. Let's go back to adding filters. I select the one variant of value option and click Create New Filter. Then I repeat the action to add filters by brand, by price, by availability, by variant options, and by characteristic. You can edit these filters after adding them. To do this, you should click on the pencil icon. In editing mode, you can edit fields. Tick the Hide the Filter checkbox to hide the filter on the website page and delete the filter. You can also change the display order for the filters. To do this, hover over the filter and drag it up or down. Let's go to the website page and see what we've got. I refresh the page and see the filters I've added. The cards can be filtered now. The letters values in the filters are sorted in alphabetical order, and the numeric values in ascending order. By the way, filter styles can be modified. To do this, go to the settings of the block with product cards, and go to the filters and store categories tab. You can hide filters by checking the box and change the text color and text options. I'll change letter spacing, and check the uppercase box to capitalize the text. To apply changes, I click Save and Close, and publish the page. You can see that the filter styles have changed. Note that just filters that correspond with details specified in the product cards are displayed on the page. For example, if you haven't added brand information to the product card on the page, there will be no filtering by brand on the page. Now let's see how to add the search field and sorting options. To do this, let's go back to the product catalog by clicking the Products tab, go to the filtering settings, and check the Show Search field and Show Sort Controls boxes. Go to the page and refresh it. The search field and sorting are available now. If you use the search field, you can search by the product title, brand, SKU, description, and text in the product card. For example, if you type vase here, The product cards containing this port will be displayed. If you type this SKU, you'll have the product for this SKU displayed. Sorting is done in the order that the cards are arranged in the product catalog by default. You can select to sort products by price, low to high or high to low, by title, and by date of product's addition to the catalog, new first or old first. If you have questions, have a look at our help center that gets updated regularly. Thanks for watching and good luck with creating wonderful websites. Bye!